All right, welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to be talking about a project that I have been working on, I guess, for a couple of weeks now. So basically, I started using NixOS about a month ago. While I was using NixOS, I came across ZanyOS, a configuration that I decided to download and start using. I kind of fell in love with it. It's very well put together. But during my journey in doing so, there was a couple of things that I wanted to change, you know, within that OS. And a few people had asked me to create my own because they like the style and different things that I've added to my own configuration. This is my first time ever really creating .files, and I'm also new to NixOS. Please be easy on me. If you have any suggestions, join the Discord, create a section for you guys to add your comments, your issues, or any suggestions. You can join in the description below. And we can talk about it and see what other things you want me to add in the future. But this is a kind of a beta version, the very, very first version I'm going to release right now for you guys to install and try out. It will work on pretty much any hardware. I've even installed it on a Steam Deck and it worked. And it does have a Steam mode that you can launch when you log in. You have to have a keyboard attached to put in your password to get in there. But anyways, I kind of just want to show you guys around and show you guys some things I have set up here. This is my configuration. The default wallpaper is not this one, but you will get the one that's in the photo here. But there's a bunch of different wallpapers that you can change and pick from. I am using Stylix for the styling. It automatically changes the waybar styling and a bunch of different apps like your file manager, your terminal, and some other apps as well will automatically update the color scheme based on whatever wallpaper you select for the Stylix. That's a nice feature there. And so if we actually jump into the actual configuration here, you can have multiple different hosts. So I have two different hosts in my configuration right now. You'll have one by default, but I do have some scripts enabled for you to be able to create new host and then, you know, add those to your own configuration. And so for instance, under my desktop one here, as you can see, you can define what your default browser is and what your monitor setup is. This is the Hyprland Dotfiles configuration on NixOS. You can see here, this is where I defined my Alex image. And then we have some different features that you can enable. A lot of these are disabled by default just to make the installation a little bit quicker, but you can enable the NFS Thunar as your Thunar as your file manager is enabled by default. I do have some controller support that you can enable. This enables you to use like different types of gyro controllers, Xbox controllers, PlayStation controllers, Nintendo controllers, all the support for controllers because I am a controller head and I enjoy using them. You may have seen it in some of my other content. I do have that flag enabled, not enabled by default, but you can enable it. And then you also do have a Flutter enable. It took me a while to get that working, so I just added that in there because I do use that for work. And also have the option for vCine launcher. It's a little bit different of a launcher that you have on a Rofi or something, so you can enable this one, which I just really like. It's a great launcher. You can actually do a lot of customization with it, change your font and everything within this little GUI here, your theme, everything within here. And they have a bunch of extensions that you can play with and use as well. So I did have that option to be enabled, and also sync thing to be enabled in there as well. And then the greeter, I actually have a lie enabled as a matrix animation on the greeter when you log in. Thanks to D-Dubs from my Discord, he put me onto that one. And so I stole it from him and installed it on my own. So that is on there by default. Let me zoom in real quick so you can see all this. I have a very large resolution screen, so you can see everything that we have here. You can also go into where all the packages will be. The packages are in modules, core, and then packages. By default, you'll see all of these packages in here. You can add new ones that you want to have installed. A lot of these will be commented out by default because they're ones that, you know, I use that you won't actually need. But if you want them, you can obviously uncomment them and then do a rebuild, and you'll have those in your configuration as well. And then I have all of the Hyprland configuration here. Did I add an option to have different keybinds and window rules per host? So that way you can have different applications and things installed on each host. If you have multiple, I need that. I just had that as a little bit easier of a way to enable that and have different hosts and window rules based on whichever host that you have on your desktop at the time. By default, it is using Rofi and the waybar. And there's a few waybars in here from the ZanyOS configuration. This one is using the D-Dubs one as well. You know, shout out to D-Dubs. He's been helping me out a lot and getting me to this point where I can actually share this with you guys. So shout out to him for helping me out and all of his different configurations that I've used within this actual installation here. The best way to find out everything that I have here is to try it out on your own. You can spin it up in a VM or on actual hardware if you want to. And to install it, it's really easy to install. All you have to do is a fresh install of NixOS, and then you can go through all of the prompts, just doing the GUI installer here. And if you want to for the desktop, I would just choose to make it easy for yourself once you get in here to have a browser and a terminal to install everything. Once you have everything installed, which that part is probably the easiest part for you, you then would go to my GitLab. Once you're on the GitLab, you would just go down to the actual installation portion here. You can see that you have this prompt that you need to run. So you just copy that and then run that in a terminal. So once you run that in the terminal, it'll install those dependencies that you need to run the script. And then once you have those, you copy the script itself and paste that in. The script will run. It's simple and straightforward. You just have to define what you want your host name to be and your name and stuff in there to be for the directory. And then also defining if what GPU, it should automatically detect which GPU you have. If it doesn't, then they'll give you the selection to select which one that you do want. And then from there, you just choose your host name. It's automatically going to pick the host name that you already have on the system when you created it. Then you can go through and install, or it'll actually clone the repo and then install the actual .files. It is pretty simple and straightforward to do. If you have issues with it, please join the Discord and let me know what's going on. I can help you out the best I can. And I have some people in the Discord that is willing to help as well. So definitely give these a shot. I'm pretty proud of it for a first try, kind of getting out my own .files, which people have asked me for in the past. I decided to get around and actually do it. So definitely let me know what you guys think in the comments below, if you're going to try it, if anything that you want to see or have me add to it. And then I'll catch you guys in the next one. Peace.